And it's time for Daily Top 5!
Yes!
4, 3, 2, 1,
let's go!
Hey, 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 I love it. All right, guys, just because it's Thursday and you know how much we love getting nostalgic, we will be throwing it back to those sweets we loved back in the day. If you can relate, come closer. Let me tell you something. Stop claiming young girl, no G. So 80s and 90s babies, get in here. Are you ready? Let's do this. Number one, Goody Goody. Yes, Goody Goody gave us some of the sweetest childhood memories. Remember, it was a delicious caramel chewy candy that children could sell their parents for. I remember this.
Goody,
oh my gosh.
Goody.
I absolutely loved Goody Goody.
Like, Goody Goody, yes.
Sometimes it's like I had a love-hate relationship with Goody Goody, because when they are chewing it and it gets stuck in your teeth, then you're like spending like 2 minutes and
But it's part of the fun. It's part of the fun.
Oh my goodness.
And I found that some were too hard sometimes, but like those ones that were just right, just the right amount of soft, just the right amount of chewy, mad.
So you were feeling the texture.
As a Goody Goody connoisseur. Yeah,
that level.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
Wow. I mean, I'm sure you love Goody Goody as well. The second sweet on our list is Kiddy. Now you can't even tell me you don't remember that. Cute little chocolate with vanilla and chocolate flavors. And the fun part of consuming this one was licking it clean because of that little spoon that could not reach the corners.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you just threw away the spoon and then you start or you turn it upside down.
No, I can relate it to when you're eating jollof rice and chicken and then you're using a fork and knife and then you get to the chicken. There are some parts that the knife won't reach. You know? So you have to use your hands, what I mean?
But this one was so annoying because I'm like, who are you guys kidding with this spoon? Like, who are you playing with?
No, it's just to attract the children.
Because it's a walk. I carried that thing. Once I was done, I carried and I licked. You put your tongue in the corners. There's not even form. Like, we don't know what
to do. It's just so small that it will finish in no time.
Exactly.
I've not seen it recently.
No. I haven't seen it in a while. It's so interesting because there are a lot of these snacks and like sweets.
Yeah.
They still exist right now. Yeah. Like, when I was serving, I still saw Paco Biscuit. And I was like,
Paco Biscuit. But it's not like the Paco Biscuits.
It's not.
Some of them are sweet. Some of them you want to go back for that one and then you don't find it again. So it's just so funny like that. Yeah. So let's talk about banana chewing gum. Yes, this chewing gum was every child's favorite. The wrapper was filled with exciting stuff all over it, which made it look like they were learning a thing or two. Trust me, when I tell you it was a perfect excuse to get money from parents, not minding if a tooth decay was going to come knock at the door. But then it is true. So you think about all those questions and you're like, okay, maybe you could be writing an examination and then you'll be asking because there is no how you ate that. And then you now look at it. So they tell you, they talk about football, they talk about different things, if we can remember very well.
General knowledge.
So sometimes you're even saving the wrappers. So,
and it was so affordable. When I was in primary school, it was 5 for 5 naira. I know some other people might say it was like 10.
And the banana flavor to it.
Because there was also the bubblegum flavor.
I think I had another love-hate relationship with this one as well.
Yes!
Because once you start chewing it, it has this then 3 minutes later, it'd be like cement.
But there were also some that were just hard from the get-go. And I'm like, what is this? This is gum or rock? Like, I didn't get it.
So with the chewing gum again.
Headache. That you're just you're having a headache, but you're enjoying the headache. I don't know. It was very weird.
So another thing I hated about it, I wouldn't know whether with banana chewing gum, I can't remember vividly. But I know that way back we used to have chewing gums that you could blow.
Yeah.
But then with some of them, it's just so annoying that I can't play with them. Yeah. I can't
I agree with this point, actually, because over the years, I feel like the lollipops we started to get, the gum was just, like, super tiny and couldn't blow anything. Yeah. But back then, like, banana and all those guys, you could blow. Oh, I agree with that.
Session.
All right, guys, moving on to our number 4 sweet on the list, Choki Choki. This milk chocolate paste wrapped in a slim and long transparent wrapper was super addictive. Yo, I don't know about you, but I just couldn't get enough of it. Oh, my goodness. And there was, like, a technique to it. Like, you chew off the thing, you open it with your teeth and then you squeeze it out
very tiny
nicely in your mouth. Oh my gosh,
my goodness. This one here, no love hate relationship. This one is love. Like, it did no wrong to me.
Loved it. Couldn't get enough.
Yeah, right. Okay, so let's talk about bazooka chewing gum. Like, this one, you can blow it, like, and then the comic lovers will definitely remember this one because it came with several editions of the bazooka comic strip you could read while you chewed.
Yeah.